The final goal of this tutorial is to learn how to calculate real-world coordinates of an object recognized by a neural network. Any neural network can be used. In this tutorial, we will be using YOLO. Let's begin from theory. How to determine coordinates of a point in the image, from a scene? To solve this problem, perspective projection transformation is used. To fully understand the mechanics of perspective projection transformation, we need to study optics. In this tutorial, we will not go deep into the theory of optics. A very simple model will be used to understand the basics of perspective projection transformation. Let's imagine that we have a dot in the coordinate system. Here some assumptions are made. The center of the projection coincides with the origin of the world. The camera axis is aligned with the world's z-axis. To simplify the derivation of the perspective projection equations, we assume that the image plane is in front of the center of projection. We need to find the coordinate of the point projected on the image plane. Using the triangle similarity rule, xi and yi can easily be calculated. In the previous step, point coordinate in the camera's image system was calculated. Now we need to convert it to the image coordinate system used in image processing. We do this by moving the origin from the center to the left upper side of the image. We have derived the formula to calculate point coordinates projected to image in the camera. How to obtain focal length and optical centers will be described in the code explanation part. Now we are moving on to our initial problem, how to determine coordinates of a point in the scene from an image. If we transform the previous equation, x and y are described as in equation 1. But there is a problem. Z cannot be obtained from a usual camera. This is where a depth camera comes in handy. Here is how this problem can be solved. From the recognition result, coordinates of the center point of the object can be calculated. From the depth camera image, the depth value of the pixel with the center point coordinates is obtained. This depth value is the Z value we needed. By substituting the Z value to equation 1, X and Y coordinates can be obtained. If the camera's coordinate system is not the same as your main coordinate system, we need to do coordinate transformation. Let's assume that the camera is displaced along the x-axis by angle theta and is translationally displaced by some amount along y and z-axis. In this case, the calculations are done like in the equation below. RealSense D435 can be used with two standards, USB 3.2 and USB 2.0. It is recommended to use with USB 3.2 since there are more options in resolution setting. Note, resolution of the stereo image and RGB camera should be the same to get proper depth value. In this part, I assume that you can execute a usual YOLO V3 program. If not, please also watch these two tutorials. Firstly, the detect image function should be modified. In the original code, this function returns only image, but we make it return an array of center coordinates of detected objects. In detect video function, here the image size, format and frame rate are defined. This chunk means that we start pipeline streaming with a previously defined configuration. The alignment utility performs per pixel geometric transformation based on the depth data. In this line, camera focal distance and optical centers are obtained. Here we get aligned frames from RGB and depth camera. In this part of the code, each arrived frame is converted to numpy array. Here, YOLO performs recognition task. In the for loop, the distance to each detected object center is calculated. Here, based on the equation 2, coordinates of the object in the real world are calculated. Here, coordinate transformation is done. In this tutorial, theta is 0. Here, rounding is done. Now let's move on to the experiment. Execute YOLO PY file. This kind of experiment should be done with precise equipment, but we will use what we have. I hope this will give you idea of how it works. The center of the coordinate system is the middle point of the RealSense front face. As you can see, the depth value is pretty accurate. It seems to be in about plus minus 2 mm error range. Y coordinates error range seems to be bigger. This is mainly because the boundary box coordinates change non-linearly. But with more precise recognition and with proper calibration of the camera, it seems to be the good way to estimate position of an object in the real world.